Hello, and welcome to the quick setup overview video of how to use the Path System plugin in practice. Path System allows you to create simple paths with Bezier splines. So let's create one. If you'd like to create a brand new path from scratch, just go to the hierarchy, create other Path System, and choose one of the presets. Now you can edit the path. Just select the path object and you can edit the nodes by just clicking on them and moving them around. If you feel the node handles are too large, just play around with the path handle size field. Same for the labels. You can very easily add or insert a new node, or you can remove the currently selected node or remove the very last node. Let's use the Bezier curves. Just enable Use Bezier Curves field and there we go. Each node will appear with two handles. First for the general node transform and the second for the node Bezier point. Bezier curves will help you to create smooth paths. There is another way of how to create a simple path. For this method, you are required to have at least some colliders in your scene. We are going to cast rays into the scene, so the colliders are required. I've got a scene here with some basic colliders environment. So let's draw our path. Go to the window and select Path Creator. The window will show up and you can select drawing mode. You can draw freely or draw your path with lines. As the hint is described at the very top, locate your cursor on object with collider and hold left shift to draw. You can see the nodes and lines are being created. If you are not satisfied with the results, just undo your actions or edit the path manually. There is one more method of how to create a path. You can use existing root object with its children that will represent path nodes. Select the root object that contains children, add path system branch component, and there you go. Also, you don't have to use the handle editor for editing your path. You can just freely select the children and do whatever you want inside the root object. Also, you don't have to use just the root's children. You can receive target nodes by tag, specific script, or you can assign the nodes manually. Let's make something practical. Let's create a cableway. I've got my scene ready, which is, by the way, included in the package, so don't mind to use that on your own. I'm going to create a preset path and edit the nodes along the cable towers. As it's everything ready, I can choose my cabin. Add a path system object component assigned to the target branch, and there we go. Now we can play around with the parameters so it looks natural. I would definitely enable the radial type and decrease the minimum node distance so it doesn't look like it's floating. Also, there are two other important categories, and that's volume transitions and speed parameters. Volume transitions control how smoothly the object will follow the path. Speed parameters control how fast the object will follow the path. So don't get confused between these two, especially movement smooth and default speed. Default speed controls the actual physical object speed. Movement smooth controls the actual smoothness of the object. There are plenty of other features of how the object will behave on the path. For example, the object is able to constantly look at a specific target while following the path. Or you can use artificial gravity so it looks much more natural. Alright, I hope I have mentioned everything important and this documentation video was helpful for you. Thanks for watching and good luck!